What's up, guys? It's Chase from Chase's Workshop. This video, I'm going to go over wiring up the pickup winder. It's not very hard at all. I've had a couple questions about it, so I just figured I'd do a video to squash any questions you might have with it. There's four components here, and there's five components in the whole thing. And I've had some people ask about this counter right here, how to wire it up, and it's battery powered. So this thing is totally separate from any of this stuff here. And I might do a little short hookup of that at the end of this video. But anyways, we got four components for the motor itself and the speed controller. You got your power supply right here. You got your speed controller right here. You've got your double pole, double throw, on, off, on switch right here. And then you have your motor. Okay? Now, the only thing I want to add to this one is I do need to put some type of fuse between this power supply and our board here. So when this power comes in, I'm going to put a fuse, probably a 1 to 2 amp fuse on this wire here before it comes to this. That way, if anything goes wrong, at least it won't fry any of our electronics and stuff like that in our pickup winder. Now, these two wires here, you can see one's red and one's black, and normally your positive is your red and your negative is your black, but I wouldn't trust that. I would at least get a multimeter out and just make sure that the red's a positive and the black's a negative, just to make sure. Now, these two wires here come straight into your, this one's gonna go through a fuse and it's gonna come straight into your board here. And where you see where it says power negative and power positive. So if we go red's positive, black's negative, they're going to wire in just like that. They're going to come right into those pins there, which would be these two right here. And then this motor negative, motor positive right here is going to come off of this and go to the center pins on your switch, which would be this pin and this pin right here. Be these two middle pins. So a motor positive will go to one side, a motor negative will go to the other side. Now the motor is going to wire into one side of that. It's either going to, you can wire it into this side or you can wire it into this side. So you can have a positive going here and a negative going here. You can flip it if you want to, negative, positive. You can flip the switch around and go either way. It doesn't matter on that. So we've got our motor positive, motor negative coming to our center here. And we've got these two wires going to this end right here, like so. Now all we gotta do is just put a jumper, two jumpers. One's gonna go from this pin to this pin, and one's gonna go from this pin to this top pin right here. And it's wired up. That's all there is to it. Now on the back of the counter, your actual magnet switch, which is this thing right here, it's got two wires in it. They're going to wire up to right here. There's one that says reset. You can put a reset switch to where you can reset the counter. And then these two wires right here are going to wire in right here. And then put a battery in it, and this thing will start counting. Okay? So now I'm going to wire all this stuff up and see if it works. Okay, so if you can see it, got these two, this orange and black wire right here, it's going to our center pin. That's what's going to go to our speed controller. And then we've got two jumpers, one going from this side, the purple, going to this one here, and the brown going from this one to this one. And then the motor just wires right off the front of that one. So it's going to look something like that. That's basically the switch. So now we're going to wire everything up and pray that it all works like it's supposed to. All right, I'm gonna start with the power. So I've got a plus right here, which is this middle one. before we do that, I'm going to check and make sure that this is my positive here and this is my negative. So I don't know if you can see this or not, but I've got the positive probe and the negative probe, and I'm just going to go from positive to negative on this wire here and see what I get. So I got 12.28 volts. Now, if that said negative 12.28 volts, it should say negative. You see the little negative? I don't know if you can see it or not, but there's a little negative sign right there next to that. That would mean that they're reversed. So red to red, black to black. Got 12.28 volts, and I don't have a negative, so the red is our positive. Now I'm gonna wire this thing up. So I'm gonna look on the back here. It says power plus right there, which is that one, and then power negative is right there. So I'm gonna go positive to positive, negative to negative, and negative to negative, right, like so. And like I said, I want to get some fuses to put in here on these things too, because I'm going to put a fuse between here and here once I get all this thing together. Now, we've got our motor positive and our motor negative right here. So it doesn't matter which one of these you use. If you want to keep it the same, then just do positive to the center, and we'll do orange as the positive. And black is the negative. Like so. So we've got power coming in, we've got a power coming out going to our switch here. If you look on the back of the motor too, it's got a positive and negative too. So if you're trying to keep all that, this is gonna be your positive side, but it doesn't matter, because when you reverse the switch, it's gonna switch them anyways. But let's see what this does. Alright, so there it is. Now, the fun part's cutting it all on and seeing if it works. Alright, so we've got cut it on. So we're going that way now. I'm going to shut it off and go the opposite way. So our switch is wired up right. I actually got a helicopter going here. This is actually a lot more than the one that I have. This one's a lot more. You can adjust. It seems like it starts better. So you can spin a lot slower with it too, which is nice. So let's flip the switch. Let's go the opposite way. Guys, I hope this makes sense to you. If you have any questions or anything about any of this stuff, like I said, please ask me, and I'd be glad to help you out. I would have had this done a lot long time ago, but I waited like a month and a half for this board right here to get here. And I wanted to use the same, you know, mostly the same components that I put on the thing there, minus the switch, because, like I said, I've got two more of these things sitting in here. And these are a lot harder to solder up, where the ones that I put on there, you can actually have terminals where you can, you don't have to solder it if you don't want to. Okay? Like I said, if you have any questions or comments, leave them below. If you like the video, give me a like. And if you like it, please subscribe. Thanks for watching, guys.